The SPCA says its first conviction of its kind has been achieved in Nova Scotia. They say they were able to show that a dog suffered undue anxiety after being whipped repeatedly with a leash, and a warning that the following video is violent. 31-year-old Adam DeCoste from Halifax pleaded guilty last week in provincial court to animal cruelty. On a security video, he's shown entering an apartment building, dropping a beverage, and then repeatedly whipping the dog, Sophie, a husky. The man was fined $1,000 and is not allowed to own an animal for 3 years. Joanne Landsburg is the chief provincial inspector with the Nova Scotia SPCA. So, Joanne, what happened? What type of abuse did the dog, Sophie, suffer?
So in this particular case, we received a complaint came in that an individual had some video footage of the dog being abused in an apartment complex. It was alleged that the person had been beating on the dog several times with a leash. So we were able to obtain that footage and view for ourselves and just to see exactly what had occurred.
And what were you able to prove the dog suffered?
Yeah, so in cases like this, you know, it's difficult for us to prove if the dog actually had physical injuries from this, you know, broken bones, or there was no broken bones, there was no physical evidence of any bruising. But what we were able to secure was that the dog suffered psychologically from the incident. And based on the video footage, we were able to submit that to an expert, and she was able to analyze the video footage frame by frame and just to see exactly how the dog reacted to the beating, and which led us to the conclusion that the dog suffered psychologically.
And how did the dog react?
So there's many things that they'll look for in cases like this. You know, the dog will be cowering, they'll be licking their lips, lifting their paws, ears back, you know, tail tucked between their legs. Those are clear indicators to us that the dog is not liking what's going on and they're suffering as a result of that beating that she had.
DeCoste was fined $1,000, received an ownership ban of 3 years. Do you think that's adequate?
I don't think it's adequate. I think it doesn't send a strong enough message that, you know, this is not acceptable, you know, behavior towards a dog. The thing is, what we're happy with is that there is a conviction on this case, and that's the circumstances surrounding the conviction was that the dog suffered psychologically. So we are looking at the overall conviction on this case, a success for animal welfare in Nova Scotia.
And why is that so significant? Give me a sense of the landscape here.
Well, it's significant because, you know, animals do suffer psychologically, and how do we prove this? This, you know, case will, you know, hopefully be able to be published and used as case law for future cases ahead of us, where we can prove that animals, you know, have feelings. They are afraid of their abusers, and that it does affect them.
Joanne, how is Sophie doing now?
So I understand she's doing very well. She was adopted out into a new home back in October. So she's doing much better now that she's in safe hands.
Thanks so much for your time. Appreciate it, Joanne.
Thank you.